प्रणमामि सदा प्रभुपादपदं प्रणमामि सदा प्रभुपादपदं
I can speak one incident through which you can clearly understand the mood of Prabhupada. One day, one very, very famous pleader coming from Calcutta to take darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to visit Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to take darshan of deity, everything. And naturally, they know the name of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Deva Prabhupada, they know is a great Pandit. They wanted to meet with him. So they coming to Mayapur and they wanted to take darshan of Vigraha, Mandir, everything, and after that prasadam surely, and after that they wanted to hear something from Prabhupada. But Prabhupada is antaryami, knowing everything. So Prabhupada could realize they have false ego. So Prabhupada didn't want to waste his time. First of all, Prabhupada wanted to provide a kick on their false ego to break. That day you are speaking, na? The room, the quarter, the flat of our false ego is standing on four pillars. What is that four pillar? Janmai sajya sutar srivi redhamana madahappamana. Kuntadevi is speaking. Janmo, we are taking birth in a very nice family. Aisarjya means big aisarjya, appliances. Sruto, big pandit, they are knowing all, you know, shastra, or materially they are educated. Sruto actually is shastra. Sruto actually not material education. But still, what Kuntadevi want to mean, that I want to say. So they are big pandit, Sruto Sri, and looking very good, nice looking. In that case, those are the four pillars. On the basis of you are going to make your nice room of false ego. And inside that room, you are going to take rest very nicely. It is your mood, it is your behavior, and naturally. So Prabhupada always wanted to break that room. That room is very fragile. Fragile means, you know, can break down any time. Like grass, if you strike with one stone piece, can, you know, become, it can break down into pieces. So this way, Prabhupada, when they are coming to hear some Harikatha from Prabhupada, to break their false ego, Prabhupada speaking to them, well, you like to hear Harikatha, you go to this, you know, this garden near Govinda Mandir. There is one garden. One brahmachari doing some seva, horticulture seva, in, you know, flower garden. You can go and hear Harikatha from him. You can go and we like to hear. No, you go. He's very nice. He can speak. Then they are going to that garden and they discover one brahmachari with gamcha and all dust, you know, on body, full body, doing some, you know, some horticulture seva there, giving watering, this, that. And they are surprised. Well, there is no sadhu. Who can speak Harikatha? Then they again come back to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, there is no sadhu. From where we can hear? There is nobody. Yes, some gardener is there, is giving water to... Yes, I mean, his Brahmaji is great Pandit. You go and hear. Then Prabhupada again sent them. When they are approaching that Brahmachari that they thought that he is ordinary gardener, they are requesting him, Prabhupada, send us to you. Why? Prabhupada sent? Yes, Prabhupada sent. To hear Harikatha. To me? Yes. We like to hear Harikatha from you. So he started speaking Harikatha, standing on garden, barefooted, and with gamcha, he started speaking Harikatha. After hearing for 40 minutes, they gone mad. How is this possible? An ordinary sevak of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Gauri Mahaprabhu, he can have that kind of proficiency? His erudite scholar? How is possible? Oh my God! So nobody can understand what is there inside Gauri Mahaprabhu. So you see, Prabhupada wanted to break the false ego of those material people, pleader, and they went after hearing Harikatha, they come back to Prabhupada. By then Prabhupada could realize their false ego gone. They think that we are educated, we are, you know, aristocrat family. Ah, what we can hear from a gardener, actually? But they gone mad. Oh my God. So one brahmachari and sannyasi of Gauriya Math, of Chaitanya Math, they are one big preacher. They are Vaishnava etiquette, their conduct, their behavior, their speech, their bhajan, all open before us. If you are not blind, you can see.